The last tool we're going to use is our clone stamp tool. And what this one's for is used to copy and paste specific pixels. All right, you have to select the right size brush, and with this one, we have to do a sample size just like we did with the healing tool. Is we have to hold down the Alt key to get a sample with the crosshairs, click it once, and then we can continue drawing. So one thing that you could do if you really wanted to is you could click on this eye, and then I can start drawing up here and clicking and dragging, and I could draw the eye. And I'm actually copying a specific piece from that file and from that picture. But that's not what I want to do with this picture, so I'm going to undo that and go Control Z. What I want to do is I want to fix all this up in here. All right, and I'm going to use both my spot healing tool, both my patch tool, my healing brush tool, and my clone stamp tool. All right, so I'm going to start up here with my clone stamp tool, and I'm going to sample up here, and then I'm going to continue on. Remember, sample often, otherwise you're going to run into problems and it's going to look blurry and people are going to tell that you copied that piece. So the more samples you click, the more samples you use, the better off you're going to be. And I'm going to select down here because this is a little bit darker area, so I'm going to kind of select that area and kind of try to blend it in just like that. Now I'm going to go work on the bottom portion. This area is really different colors, so we could use our patch tool down here and select different pieces and actually just try to combine different pieces with our selections. So that way we don't lose the coloring that they have in here. And to deselect, you go Control D, of course. Once you're all done, save it as a PNG file, a .png, and save it to your iDrive, and then you'll be all completed with this fixing needed.